W.L. Seton Secondary School was the host venue for a sport a lot of people probably aren't too familiar with, netball. A bit like basketball, a bit like frisbee football, the seven-a-side game features speed and quick decision-making. In this matchup, the Zone 3 representatives, Fraser Valley, in red, are facing a squad from Zone 6, Vancouver Island and the Central Coast. And it's the Coquitlam girls, with a record of 4-1 going into this game, who are proving to be a handful for the Islanders.
Most of us have played together for 4 years, all the seniors, so there's five of us. And then the other girls came this year, so it's their first year playing netball, but our coaches are national and provincial coaches too, so we have really good coaches.
What's the key to success in this sport?
I think it's consistency, because in netball, you alternate center passes, so each team has a chance to score on their own center pass. It doesn't matter who scores, the other team gets the ball next. So if you can score on your own as well as on any turnovers, then that's the key to winning the game.
I think footwork is a lot of it, but also just looking around the court a lot and trying to make sure you remember to stay 3 feet. That's a big thing.
Yeah, it's a pretty fast game, isn't it? Not a lot of time to think, right?
No, because you only have 3 seconds with the ball, so you kind of just have to get it and then look around and make a decision.
Netball is a bit like basketball, with the object to put the ball through the hoop. In fact, it was originally developed as a woman's version of the sport. But there is no traveling or dribbling, and each goal is only worth 1 point. Players can only play in a designated zone on the court. For example, the goal shooter can only play in the attacking third of the court, while goal attack can play there and the center third of the court. Sarah and Brita both play GS and GA in this game.
Sometimes I'd forget. I was like, oh no, my check is in that third. I'm allowed to go in there. I forgot, because normally I'm GS, but we decided to switch it up this time, so it's fun switching it up.
Which one do you prefer?
GS.
Why?
I used to be GA, and I liked that one, but then they started putting me GS, and I like shooting and just like kind of being in that one third more. It's just, I feel like it's more intense. I just really like how fast it is, and how it's just, I like the fact that you can't really move and you just get to pass around a lot.
How does it compare to basketball?
Well, basketball, there's almost more to think about, because you can dribble if you want, but here, you can't really think about dribbling, you just think pass or shoot. So I like that. It's not really like any other game. Like, when people go, what's netball? You can't really explain it to them. Like, it's kind of like handball, kind of like basketball, but not at all. It's different. It's fun.
You can't go within 36 inches of your opponent when they have the ball, so interceptions are a critical part of the game.
Yes, definitely anticipating the pass. So being able to read the play is really important. You can be only 3 feet away from the players, but you can always move your hands around, and whatever you can do to throw the other team off and force turnovers is the key, and just being able to just jump on any loose balls.
The girls here today are between the ages of 13 and 17. Some previously played basketball, while for others, that type of experience just wasn't necessary.
No, I've never played basketball. I'm awful at it. I'm tall. They used to try and get me to play. They watched me play, and they're like, hey, no, you're not good. I play soccer, field hockey. I dance. So that's a good thing that we have. Our team's all really athletic. We all play at least one other sport.
Height is definitely important, especially inside the shooting circle. I would say it's the speed. I mean, it's not only you have to be tall, but you have to be able to move around, because in netball, you can't dribble, and everything is based on movement and getting open.
The Fraser Valley would go on to win this game 23-5 and advance to the semifinals.
We switched positions a bit, and I thought our passing was really good. We just improved a lot since our first game yesterday.
That was the difference in the game, do you think?
Yeah, our passing was just really fast, and we were getting the crisp passes and playing aggressively.
I think it's our intensity. Most of our girls are really ball hungry. We want the ball. And a lot of our players are new, and so that intensity really comes through.
To get the updated scores on netball and all the other sports at the BC Winter Games, check out bcgames.org. Reporting from W.L. Seton Secondary School in Vernon, I'm Tim Morton for Shaw.